first I put that almighty magic right on. Oh God, no mercy. I really want you to paint. How should I explain that? I was teaching in Los Angeles for, I would say, 20 years. And a lot of artists and teachers around me was very jealous of me. They always would say, because I always talked like, it is not your fault that you can paint, it's the paint's fault. And then they would say, you have a good excuse, if they can't paint, you blame it on the paint. And the truth is, you blame it on the paint. I always had folk classes, always folk classes, because people liked the idea and they could catch on easy with this technique and with this idea. Creative power, when you think you have to create, you cannot do it over days. It is most impossible. Think about sometime the sun sets. You have a beautiful sunset. You call your kids out, you call your wife out and say, oh my God, come take a look what's going on there. Everyone is excited. Now is the right time to grab that almighty brush and fire that sunset right onto that canvas. See? Now, I just would like to you to understand, a lot of people, when I was out on the shopping centers, they would even crucify me. They would say, oh, he's knocking off his paintings, they are no good, he's done, he just does it so fast. It took me first a lifetime to get there, and it's a wonderful thing when you can unload something now. You understand that? It got to be now. I don't want to wait for tomorrow. That sunset becomes muddy tomorrow already, and I know nothing about the sunset anymore. That moment where you're fresh and where the power, where God give you your blood going through the veins, that is the moment. Oh God! Spit in your hand like you grabbed the almighty shovel and fire it on that almighty canvas. There you are. See, that makes a powerful artist. That makes good living. That makes laughing. And you know, when I'm finished with my paintings, I'm exhausted. I'm quite, but I'm happy. I'm so devil happy I did a living painting. That painting is alive. I hope you understand that. Because this is my technique and that's my way of living, and I was very successful. I didn't do too bad with that. Even if in the beginning a lot of people hollered at me, that guy don't know what he's doing, he's knocking off paint, but it was usually another jealous artist. He couldn't get it going. There are a lot of starving artists. There are a lot of hungry artists. But look at my stomach. I'm a happy, fat artist. Ah, ha, ha, you see that? And I think that's better. Don't matter if I die hungry or if I die fat, but at least when I'm fat, the undertaker has something to lift. Isn't that? Okay. See, you have to prepare the whole world. See, because I'm next to God, I got the power to see the whole world. I have my hands around the whole world. And I create a part of what God gave me. See, this is a wonderful thing to think about. You hear me talking on all my TV shows, you are next to God. I believe that. 100% I believe it. I'm better than the Pope and better than the Ayatollah. That's the funny part, because I have set myself so high. There's so much power in me. And I wish you would grab that almighty power too. It is there, and God gives you that. Because creative power is a separate power. You don't go out and want to cheat other people or want to make an extra buck for nothing. You create this wonderful God-made world. You create a part of it. And I always feel when I'm finished, God has his hand on my hair, on my head, and he says, Bill, you did a wonderful job. And I think if you think like that, you are in good shape. Use your almighty palette knife now. Isn't that funny? When I can't help, I have to say, it's almighty hand, it's almighty palette knife, it's almighty palette, it's almighty paint. You know, you build yourself up. That is like you go middle in the, through the night, you go through the wilderness, through the bush. and you hear the dogs howling, and you want, I'm scared, but I talk loud, I start singing, because I'm scared. You see what I do here? I'm scared. No, no, I got a powerful hand. I got a powerful knife in my hands. I got a powerful palate. It's all Almighty. You know that it builds you up? All my talks, they are 70 years old now, because I need some extra help. You are still a human being. You are still a human being. God have made you with what you are. And you can't help what you are. But in order to build yourself up, God give us that extra in our brain to build ourselves up. See, that's what I always like to say in all my classes. You know, a newcomer comes in. As a sample, someone came in, special all the ladies. Oh, Mr. Alexander, could you help me here? Could you help me here? And out of that came, fire in! Don't you worry about whatever. Ruin that first canvas. See, people are so timid first. They think an artist, he sits on a chair and he fiddles and fiddles and doodles for 3 months on a lousy painting. He's dead. Dead artist doing that. But not the artist was just alive. You understand this whole idea. I wash my almighty brush. You know, it's a wonderful thing. I have young fellas working on my land. Have a hatchery. I need always lots of gravel shoveled around, and in the creek they have, in the summertime it's beautiful being in the creek. And you know, those kids doing the same thing. When I hear them, he said, give me that almighty shovel, put that almighty stone out there. The kids are already brainwashed by on my land to say almighty, and I like that. The kids become powerful already, because it's good when they say that. I enjoy that always. I say nothing, but I laugh. I have a big smirk on my lips, but I feel it's good. They see that's almighty shovel. That's almighty stone they have to lift. They have to roll that over. See? That is not only on the canvas. That's on your home. It should be in your kitchen. Lift up that almighty frying pan with almighty eggs in there. All right, and you fire in, and look, your stomach is laughing. That's good. I think that part is in the sunshine now. I put it in the sunshine. Who are you to put it in the sunshine? Because I'm next to God. You understand it now. You see, if you think like that, then you have the right to do it. Really, a lot of guys sometimes on my shows, they would say, who are you to say that? Because I'm next to God and I'm an almighty artist. When I talk about myself, I wish you would talk about yourself like that. You are the almighty artist. You are next to God and you have the right to do it. I will not be there. The time will come where, and I would love to look down to the world and would say, isn't that nice, Johnny and Betty and all those? They're firing, they're next to God, they're so powerful. When they come up to heaven, I open the door for them. But I want to tell you, you got to experience this life on the mountains, to paint those mountains. The same you have to experience the life of a farmer. You have to go to Montana. And I was there. It's just, I like, America has such beautiful, beautiful places. Albuquerque, you know. Oh God, when you think into the desert and out of the trees into the desert, it is the mood, your mood is changing. See, you're an artist. I tell you, people that cannot understand that should never paint. That's the same like musicians. When you're born, I was a born musician. God gave me the fiddle when I was born, and I made that fiddle when I was young. I made the guys dance like crazy. The heels was flying like crazy. And I never learned a note, but I could harmonize. I could make that fiddle do things. Certain people are born for certain things. And that's what you can maybe learn a little bit. And I hope I can leave a good impression on you. If you have that talent, it is born, you are born with that, I hope I can bring it out. And I hope I can bring it out in you, and you will see a happier living. Your girlfriend will love you. Ah, she will hit, he will kiss you and hug you. Because not only this, you have a happy life, you make a happy buck. See, people like happy people. When you go to a shopping center and you see someone the background music and you hear someone whistling, I always follow them usually. I always think, oh my God, this is a happy individual. He whistles with the song. He is content. He is happy with himself. That is, people go on drugs for lousy happiness. Oh God, oh God, I feel so sorry for them. They should come to me. I make you happy. Love you.